than that, and it just require a few grooming after once a week. And likewise, cats are also very easy to keep because very less grooming is required. You just have to brush their hair if they are long-coated cats, and you just also have to clean their eyes and nose. Other than that, other than this, there is nothing much required in terms of a cat. But yes, in foreign countries, many people keep very strange pets at their home. Like I heard once that a girl somewhere in abroad keep a python as a pet. So when it comes to such strange animals, then the person who is keeping them should keep in mind their requirements and the possible danger as well. Because I also read a news in the newspaper that in a foreigner specifically a girl kept a python at home as a pet, and she even sleeps with that python, and it was her habit. And once she realized that her python, when she sleep with him, her python starts to circle around her, and she was assuming that she is not giving her python the full food that he required. So she took that python to a vet, and the vet told her that he is not circling you for the sake of food, and because he was feeling hungry, but he was planning to kill you, because it is the nature of python that they kill their animal by inhibiting or by creating an hindrance in their breathing system. So they are called as the contractors. So I think if a person keep these type of dangerous animal as a pet, so he should keep in mind all the natural behaviors and all the natural things and or the signals that they give before the attack. And I think other than this, the management is quite easier when it comes to pets. And above all, I think above all, many diseases that are very much prevalent among animal is because of the poor management. And if we manage them properly, then we can avoid a lot of diseases. Like, I think it is very much important to prevent the disease rather than treat the disease, because treatment requires a lot of money. And irrespective to it, if a person pay much attention towards the vaccination and the deworming of the animal, then keep his animal very healthy, and he can avoid many diseases. So I think the feeding and the natural habitat and their preventive measures are very much necessary when you are keeping the animal at home. And I think if a person is not able to give all the necessities to an animal, then it is better to not keep an animal at home.
Okay, very good. Very nice. Very great fluency that you have. And I didn't disturb you in between, though some questions came to my mind. Okay. So I do think that there are some diseases that can transmit from animals to human beings if we keep the animals as pets or some other animals.
Yes. Yes, all the diseases that are transmitted to you are talking about the diseases that can be transmitted to human beings.
Yes, from animals, keeping animals,
Yes,
if we have domestic
yes,
animals,
yes, yes.
they need cleanliness.
Yes.
I have seen that from their environment because they are kept in a small place.
Yes, of course. I can answer it for you. Yes, there are a lot of diseases can be transmitted from animals to human beings, and these diseases are called as zoonotic diseases. And most of the diseases are related to reproduction, like the trichomoniasis cells is a problem that is related to reproduction, and it comes with the close contact of female cats. And there are also very much diseases like rabies. Rabies is very easily transmitted to human beings. Other than this, tetanus is also very common, and ringworm infection is very common, and it is a skin disease, and it is basically a fungal disease that is very easily transmitted from animals to humans, and by the close contact. And other than this, Congo virus is very common these days, and it is because of the ectoparasites that are on the body of animals. They are called as ticks, and the virus remains in the mouth of ticks, and when this tick bite a human being, then the virus is transmitted into the human. But the virus did not cause disease in animals, because animals are considered as an intermediate host for them. So the disease is not very much common in animals, but it is very lethal and untreatable in human beings.
Oh, very good. So and now we come to the questions, and it's about health. Okay. So what type of questions that they are expected to be asked to you when you appear for the test? So the first one you told me, is it important to you to eat healthy foods? Yes, you told me it's very important to eat healthy foods. So now, next question in this line is, if you catch colds, what do you do to help you feel better and why?
To catch a cold is very common these days because of a lot of viruses are present in our environment, and because of there is no rain at all these days, which is very much necessary. So it is very easy these days to catch a cold, and whenever I catch a cold, then first of all I go for home remedies. I started to take honey water, and I also put ginger in my tea, and I also use Vicks because it gives a very soothing effect when I feel congested nose. And other than this, I also take steam because it also opens my sinuses when they are congested, and I feel very comfortable after taking steam. And other than this, if the situation aggravates and worsens, then I will definitely go to doctor to see. To seek physician's help.
What is your opinion about self-medication?
Self-medication can be very helpful sometimes, but I don't think so that self-medication with drugs is very good idea, because I think every time when we get sick, the problem may varies, and but if we try our past experiences and just follow our past prescriptions, then sometimes they could be helpful, but they can be at the same time they can be very harmful if the reason is not same as previous. So in such situations, the self-medication can be harmful, but it is a good idea to treat yourself with the home ingredients that are very common and are very helpful and have a very good researched background. These ingredients can be used firstly to treat a disease or minor symptoms, but if the situation is very worse and very difficult, then I think a person should go to the doctor immediately.
So in the past, we see that there were less number of doctors, and almost all mothers, they were doctors. Okay.
Yes.
Minor ailments like cold, fever, they treated themselves. They were not educated, but they had very good manners to take care of the children, to keep them safe from the cold or fever or things like this, or sneezing. Rather, their children were healthy, okay? They
yes.
did not catch cold so easily, but they were all the time running or all the things. Mostly because they kept the children happy, okay? They gave them food.
Yes.
Now I see in some cases that mother. But these days, I feel what it was, sorry about the situation. When there is a mild fever to the child, or they immediately rush to the doctor for themselves, and in the time they don't get very, what I should say, the results are not very helpful. So what do you say about it? Should we run to the doctor immediately upon sneezing? Which need the time?
No, I don't think so, that to go or to rush to a doctor in minor situations or in minor symptoms, because sometimes when we start medication at a very basic level, then we develop a tendency that we develop a tendency of medicines, and we just handicapped our immune system, because nature created a self-defense system in our bodies, and whenever we come across any antigen or a foreign body or any virus or pathogen in, then our body starts to fight against against that enemy, and we should give our body some time to resolve the problem itself. But if the problem remains and symptoms aggravates and symptoms increase, then we will say have to take medicine. But I think time management and the sense when we should go to the doctor and when we should wait for the result, I think every person should have to develop this ability and this quality.
Oh, right, very good. For myself, I don't go to the doctor if I don't have a pain, and it takes years that I don't go to the doctor. Even at my 56, I don't go to the doctor. Maximum I go to a medical store and I tell that I have fever, sneezing, or if there is vomiting, and they give me some medicine that I get them. And they give me, three doses, but I take one or two doses and I don't complete the 3 months. I go that, it saves me money and time as well, and pain as well. So this is my experience. I normally don't go to the doctors. I don't think it is wise or not wise. I think I have trained my body to fight against the disease. So it is. I used to play football in the past. So maybe.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing is that it is blessing of God if I am running in this way. Okay. Do you pay attention to public information about health?
Sometimes the opinions are very much important and helpful in assessing some particular thing. For example, unfortunately, if I have to go to a hospital, or for myself or some because of some relative, then I will first of all go through the reviews of the people that already have experience of that particular hospital. Then I will decide that which hospital is good and has a good reputation. Then I think in such scenarios, the opinions are very much important. Because by the use of experiences of other people, we can just avoid many mistakes, and we can avoid failures. But every person has his own opinion and his own thinking. I mean to say that it there is a chance that if a thing is not proved fruitful for someone, then it doesn't mean that particular thing has no benefits, and maybe it will prove very fruitful for someone. So I think yes, opinions are very important, and they play very important role, but up to some extent. You can just not rely on others' opinion and other suggestions. Nature give you your own brain, so you should think by yourself after concluding a final decision or final stance.
All right. So my personal opinion is that the young children, people, you see, the children, especially between 10 to 20 or 10 to 30, you can say, they carry a lot of bacteria, viruses, all types of things that they carry with them. But they are not affected mm-hmm. by these, you see, disease
mm-hmm.
Carrying, you see, viruses or bacteria. They are not affected because their body has very healthy immune system, and they can resist mm-hmm. other things. And but
yes.
they carry diseases with them all the time. When they meet mm-hmm. some old people, so they transmit their, you see, bacteria, viruses to them. And because the old people, they have, you see, less level of immunity.
Immunity.
And the diet, yes. Exactly. Is that the correct thinking? Does it happen?
Yes, some of the pathogens really transmit, and really depends upon the immunity of person. But I don't think so that it is a universal rule that every young person has have a very strong immunity. We are facing a very critical situation these days. Like I am referring towards the pandemic which we are dealing with. These days, the pattern is very much strange. The disease is killing a massive number of youngsters, and at the same time, the disease is affecting elders likewise. But it all depends upon the strength of the immunity of person. And there is no hard and fast rule that every young person must have a very strong immunity. Yes, it is true up to some extent, or you can say it is true in majority of the cases that any disease, there is the less chances of the disease to affect a young person because of their strong immunity system. It was a basically it was a perception, but it is quite proved wrong these days that I think it doesn't depends upon the immunity level of immunity does not depends upon the age. It depends upon the diet we take and the physical strength we have, and also sometimes it depends upon the genetics of a person. So I think yes, immunity really plays a very vital role in getting a disease. Whenever a person is strong and he has a very strong immune system, then it is very hard or it is very difficult for the pathogen to develop a disease in that person. But it doesn't depend upon the age of the person.
So, for example, if somebody takes the blood test or other things like, so in screening, and if a person's body is screened, it will come to know that he carries a lot of germs and diseases with him. And mm-hmm. Then a time comes that some disease, I usually say, it is automatically activated. Okay. For example, death is lying in me. Everybody has to die. That death is lying in me. And when its time comes, it becomes activated. So is it mm-hmm. that we healthy people, working, we have some diseases in us, they keep sleeping for years in us, and then when the proper time comes, they are activated and they begin to snatch life from a person? Is it real or just my imagination?
I think being a Muslim, it is our belief, and it is our belief that whatever happened in anyone's life and whatever happened with a person, it already written in our fate and destiny. So I think the matter of life and death is not because of any pathogen. We have a lot of cases when the persons have very lethal and very dangerous pathogens, and they just got sick by many many difficult to treat diseases like cancers. I saw multiple people who fight cancers, and I also saw many people who just got cancer and they just die. And I also observe many people that survive even by getting this type of lethal disease. So I think it doesn't depends upon the strength of the pathogen or the strength of the immunity. I think it already it is the matter of our destiny and fate. When time of death comes, the very minor and very weak pathogen can create a very big problem for you. And when there is no time of death, then very big and major pathogens cannot harm you at all.
So now, what do you think? How much is the role of fear in a person's life that he, you see, many of the people I've seen that they die because they have anxiety, fear in them. So how much?
I think
worries and fear. Worries and fear are the enemy of life. So how far do you see it?
You are asking about fear and what?
Worries. Worries and fear.
Worries. Worries. I think the situations or the environments or the situations that we see in our life, like if I say that I am happy and if I say that I am not happy today, it all depends upon our thoughts. I think it did not do anything with the actual situation. And if I say that I am very happy today, then if I analyze the day, then I think I will not say that this is the reason because of which I am very much happy. This is just my thought that the particular thing is making me happy and the particular thing is making me sad. I think all the things have both the aspects. Sometimes it makes me happy and sometimes it makes me unhappy. But it all depends upon our thoughts and our thinkings and our mood. But the thinking is very, the thinking has a very paramount significance in a person's life and death, because it is our belief. Then then we start to think that there is just a day remain of our life. Then it will also be a day in reality. When we give up, it means we are finishing ourselves. Otherwise, there is no force in the earth, in this world, which can defeat you or ends you. I think these things entirely depends upon the thinking of a person.
Okay, let's be now less philosophic. We have gone too far. Okay, what would you do to have a healthier lifestyle? What is important?
Sorry, what could you do to have a healthier lifestyle? Mm-hmm. Okay, these days it is very difficult to maintain a healthy lifestyle because of the overburden of the work. Because these days many people, including me, have to work for the whole day. First of all, I have to go to my work, and when I come back home, I also have to do a lot of things at my home. I also have to take care of my son. So my life is very much occupied. So I hardly find time to do things that makes my life very healthy. But I try to find some time, and most of the time I succeeded in it. To make myself healthier, I try to eat healthy food or balanced food, and I try to eat those food which are less in oil and also of less spices. And I also avoid fry items, and I also avoid junk food and fast food or processed food. And I make sure that I eat plenty of fruits and vegetables. And I also, if I do not do any of the thing, I make sure that I take plenty of water daily. And other than this, I also go for walk. And I also do some minor exercises at home that are very much healthy and are very necessary to maintain a healthy lifestyle.
What about your sleeping hours? How many hours do you sleep every day?
Yes, sleeping pattern also plays a very vital role in the life, because when we do not sleep sufficiently, then we will develop fatigue in our body, and if that fatigue remains for a longer period of time, then it will convert into chronic fatigue that is considered as the basic of many other illnesses. As I mentioned that because of a very busy lifestyle, I hardly find time to sleep sufficiently, but on daily basis, I try to sleep for 8 hours, and I make sure that if I am very much busy, unless then I make sure that I will sleep at least 6 hours a day.
So do you think 6 hours is good enough?
No, the standard and sufficient time is 8 hours. But my busy schedule did not allow me to sleep more than this period. I am trying to figure out this,
Excuse me. There are 7 days a week, okay? And you see 8 hours a day. So in a week, you need to see 56 hours sleep you need to stay healthy. So do you have 56 hours sleep every week?
Not really. Yes, not really. But this is the reason that we are very much weak internally these days, and the new diseases, we are catching new diseases, and the rate of diseased people is very increasing in our country, and I think all over the world these days. This is the basic reason, because of our complex and busy lifestyles. I try to cope up with this condition and this situation, and I try to compensate my body on weekends to sleep for longer period of time. I try to sleep more on weekends, not for entire day, but I manage to sleep for 3 to 4 hours more in the weekends, on the weekends.
Right, very good. And now we come to part two of the test. Okay, in this test, the examiner speaks like this. You will have to talk about the topic for 1 to 2 minutes, okay? You have 1 minute thing about what you are going to say. You can make some notes to help you for this. I advise you that ignore this thing, okay? And this is not very important, but they say this. It's only to create a problem for those who listen. If I were in the test, I would just take care of this. What they say, 1 minute or this or that. Okay, describe an occasion. It's not very difficult, okay? Here, describe an occasion when you had to wait a long time for someone or something to arrive, okay? Then you should see who or what you were waiting for. So this is one thing that you need to speak. And how long are you had to wait? And why are you had to wait a long time? What was the reason? And in the end, we explain how you felt about waiting a long time. So for me, waiting a long time is quite a problem. I feel very impatient. And you see, because I feel all the time in hurry. So have you ever experienced like when you're waiting for a long time for something or somebody?
Yes. Most of the time, we wait for many people.
So when it happened that you waited for somebody or something?
I will proceed with this topic by explaining that I waited for someone.
Mm-hmm.
So should I give me a minute?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Don't take a minute. There's nothing. That's a game. Okay. Take a minute. Right. No. Okay. That's a game. Okay. Don't go to that.
Okay.
It's easy. Like you are waiting for someone. Okay. Somebody. Okay. You can make a story from your own self. It's not real story.
Nobody cares
if really you are waiting or not waiting. So you just start speaking.
Okay.
Once it was, I was waiting for blah, 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 and all that.
Okay. Basically, I really hate to wait for anybody because I think to wait someone is the most difficult task in this earth. I think the waiting for someone is the most difficult task in this world. And whenever we wait for someone, it seems that time just stopped and now not moving an inch, and it is very difficult. And here I would like to talk about an event in which I waited for someone. It was basically an event of a wedding. I attended a wedding last month, I think on 24th of February, and I waited for the groom, and I know it is quite strange, but I went to the wedding. It was basically my father's friend's son wedding. Yeah, it was a wedding of our close friend. And the groom was, I was from the bride's side, and the wedding was planned to start at 7 o'clock in the night. And I with my all other family members went to that wedding. And when we reached there, the mother of the bride told us that groom is not arrived yet, because he was intended to come from Dubai. He worked there, and because of some issue at his working place, he could not manage to come earlier. So he was intended to come on the same day of his barat, and unfortunately, because of some issue at the airport, he did not arrive yet in Pakistan. So it was quite a strange story for us, because we did not come across such situation before. We did not came across such situation before. And
sorry, when you are using did not, then use first form.
We did not come across such situation before. And we waited. In the start of the ceremony, we just waited very. We just sit in a corner of the hall, and the initial first hour was very good, and we just stay there and we just enjoyed the environment. But gradually our curiosity and curiosity started to curiosity increases with the passage of time, because as the time is passing, our worrying and our mood start to deteriorate, and you start to deteriorate because there were no signs of groom at all. And I asked multiple times by bride's mother that are there any chances, or are there any news, is there any news, is there any news regarding the arrival of the groom? And she had no reply, and she was very worried. Not only her, the mother of the bride was worried, and I think all the guests from bride side was very worried in the start of the wedding. And they don't know that what to do and how to help the family of the family. And we waited there, and we do not have anything to do because we could not start the ceremony without the groom. And we were just spending time by calling the family of the groom, and spending our time by calling at the airport to ask about the flight there in which the groom was expected to come. We spend almost 3 to 4 hours in the same situation, and gradually when the time passes, people have nothing to do because we cannot just start the ceremonies, and we just did not have anything to do. So we just started gossiping around, and all the amusements and the enjoyment of the wedding was slightly and gradually faded away. And we were quite flabbergasted that how a groom behaved very irresponsibly, and he just not showed up at the wedding. And but we realized that the family of the bride was already very stressed and very disappointed because of the irresponsible behavior of the groom. So we just stopped asking questions, and we realized that it is not ethical, and other than ethical reasons, it is also not very good to ask questions. We should help the bride family. So we also also started to get information about it. Everyone is basically trying to do hard, but all our trying and all our efforts were not proved fruitful. And I think around 12 o'clock in the night, we just got a news from the airport that because of some weather issue and because of some technical problems, the information section of the airport was not properly working. So they apologized because of inconvenience that they did not deliver the news of the flight at time. And they also told us that now this flight is just departed from that airport, and the groom we were expecting is in the flight. So we could just a sense of relaxation and a sense of relaxation just settled over all of us. So we just took a cold and deep breath that our efforts and our stay is going to be finished, and after about 2 hours further, the groom arrived, and he was not just dressed up because of lack of time, and we were already waiting for him for I think about 6 to 7 hours, and it was quite so long, and we were okay with the attire of the groom, and when he came, the parents, both the families just finished all the rituals and the customs, and they just finished the ceremony, and we were very much amazed at the same time, and we were just relieved because of the arrival of the groom, but the entire experience was very much stressing and very much strange for me. So I think this event will remain in my memories for all of my life.
Yes, I hear it. I'm on a very light tone, wasn't there any other decent boy who could say yes to the girl and could be married, and you could say sorry to the groom, oh sorry, dear, you are late, okay. Wait for another year for your life. So this sort of situation, was it possible?
Actually, I did not basically went to that wedding, but this happens in reality. And a very close friend of me told me that her friend was intended to marry with a boy, and who was intended to come on the same day from Dubai, but he did not manage to come because of some legal issues with his visa. So his parents did a very wrong, in my thinking, did a very wrong step, and they just did their wedding on phone call, and I was just बहुत मुझे अजीब लगा कि दिस इज नॉट वेरी स्ट्रेंज
सो
ओके वेरी
इन अदर कंट्रीज दे डोंट टेक सच मैटर्स वेरी सीरियसली ओके इफ वन बॉय इज नॉट अवेलेबल एनी अदर बॉय हु इज अवेलेबल दे वुड से ओके से यस टू द मैरिज एंड दे जस्ट सेंड द ब्राइड विद दैट बॉय एंड दे से सॉरी टू द वन हु इज लेट. It's very,
yes.
They don't take marriage very seriously in other countries.
I think because this situation happened, it was not it is not seems the reality, but it happens because of the situations because of the pandemic, and everything is getting delay, and all the things around this world these days is very uncertain and very unusual.
Actually, the thing is that, you see, in such a gathering, you see, there are very so many nice and decent boys there and close relatives there, right? So they can, anyone can say, okay, yes to the bride, and marriage can be arranged easily. Okay, in the family, we know each other. So the one that is very late, okay, he should say, we should say sorry to that one that is very late, okay? The one that is available, married was the girl. I think in this way, if I just was thinking, okay, that bride would be very happy that the one saved the honor of the bride and the parents. So, well, this is not see a kind of passion, so many fear or all these things. But if it were in the past, it could be easily done. Anyway, so this is that you had to wait pretty long, okay? That was not waiting, that's a kind of tragedy, you know. that would seem like this happened. In what kind of situation should people always arrive early?
On every assembly, they
should be punctual. Okay. Normally,
yes.
How is it that one kind of situation, I said, do people arrive early? Is it on birthdays?
I know. I think people only come on time when they have to attend a meeting, or when they have to catch a flight. and when they have to go to such situations or to such gathering where they cannot afford late. So in such situations, only people pay attention towards punctuality. But if they have any small chances of relaxation, then they will not pay attention towards the punctuality and towards the arrival on time.
Right. How important it is to arrive early in your country?
I think in my country, people most of the time do not pay much attention towards the punctuality. They just do all the things very sluggishly, and most of the time people got late in very important and very important situations. So I think in my country people usually do not pay much attention on punctuality and on timetables.
Right. How can modern technology help people to arrive early?
Modern technology facilitates people these days in many ways. Like now the transportation system is very advanced and very fast at the same time. I mean to say that if a person is using a public transportation medium, then he can very easily reach to his destination on time if he manages it his time properly. And other than this, we can also have a GPS system by which we can just learn, and we can just have a overlook that if there is a traffic jam on the road, so we can deviate our path, or we can take another path to reach our destination on time.
Okay, now this being patient, what kinds of job require the most patience?
I think all the jobs related to public dealing requires a lot of patience, like when you have to deal with customers. I am talking about a person who is working in marketing sector, then they should remain patient. And other than this, the doctors require to be patient in most of the time, because mostly they have to tackle very strange and very distressing situations. And other than this, teaching is also a profession that requires patience a lot.
Okay, now, is it always better to be patient in work or studies?
No, the patience always not proved fruitful, because there are various situations when you have to be quick and when you have to react very quickly and rigorously. For example, if you see a child playing with a very harmful thing like a knife or a file, then you should act quickly, and you should hold him or her, or you should hold that child quickly, and you should not wait for the accident that may happen.
So next question, last question you just got is, do you agree or disagree that the older people are the more patient they are? What is this? Do you agree or disagree? Older people are the more patient they are. What is this? This is a nonsense question.
Okay. Yes.
Do you agree that the older people are more patient? That's the thing.
Yes, I think older people are more patient as compared to youngsters, because youngsters are full of energy. They don't like to remain stuck to a particular thing. They require fast action, and they required fast reactions and fast replies, and so they are not very much patient, whereas the older people have sustainability and persistence in their behavior and in their nature. So they are more patient and they have a lot of experience. So they know very much better that how to tackle a particular situation. So they are, I think, more patient than the youngsters in most of the cases.
All right, very good. It was pretty long time that you've been in the class. Well, you spoke very well, and you deserve 9+ bands, okay? If I were your teacher,
okay.
Really, you deserve 9+. Okay, very good performance, okay? There are a few things okay. that I would like to have your attention to them. So okay. be very, pay more attention to this about present. I'm afraid you some knowledge about present past must be missing, okay? So how okay. do you identify present? There are some signs of present.
Yes, there are some signs.
There are 7 signs of present. Like in Urdu, we have okay. 4 signs, hai, hai, hu, ho. These are the 4 signs of present. So in English, there are 7 signs of present. So how do you identify them?
The helping verbs, because of the helping verbs.
Yes. How many?
Is okay. MR.
Is MR, okay.
And also by the use of first form individually.
Good, good. That is okay. So
and other than this, yes.
This thing I am writing for you, okay? Next time okay. when you are talking, I advise you that you keep these things in your mind. So always,
okay.
these words means present, okay? I don't know about okay. indefinite, continuous, this is blah, blah, okay? That's all, it makes me a problem for men. So it's easy for me to remember when I'm talking in present, I use is, am, are, has, have, subject followed by first form or can. Okay, so this makes
yes.
present. Okay, a few times it happened that you were thinking in present, but you were telling in the past, and sometimes you are thinking in the past, but you are telling me in the present. Okay, so this is
yes.
very easy. And if you have not learned, well, there are so many other things that you can learn these things, and they will help you a lot. Okay, if you keep these things in your mind, if they become the part of your knowledge, okay. And you agree to use them, you will have to, okay? And there's no way out. If you are, you see, shuffling from present to past, the listener can immediately identify this weakness of the speaker. So when you are talking in the past, you keep in mind was, were, had, and subject plus second forms. Second form is always in the past. That's a big sign of past. So S plus 2 means subject followed by second form, past indefinite. And could and would, okay? These are
okay.
the signs of past. When you are talking about the past, use these words only. Don't come to these words, okay? Particularly pay attention to them. Do not use these signs in the past, okay? If the speaker is using is, am, are, has, have, when he is narrating a story that relates to past or history or something, so then we immediately understand that he is making a mistake. Okay, examiner has this formula set consciously or unconsciously. He knows, he sticks to it very, very particularly. So future, there are 2 signs of future: will and shall. Okay, if you are using these words,
yes.
that is will or that is future. And if you don't use them, most probably you are not talking about something. Future, I told you previously that when we are talking about an action for the first time and guarantee that the action has not yet taken place, so that is the future. In that case, we use will or shall. Okay, for example, if I say, I will go to Islamabad. It means that I'm telling you this for the first time and guarantee that I have not yet gone to Islamabad, okay? So, would is the past. You see, present takes help from future signs. But past doesn't take help from future signs. Past has its own word would for future. Okay. If there are two ways of talking about future. One is that for the first time we talk about an action and the action has not yet taken place. And the other mentioning of future is that we have already talked about an action, okay, that is intended to take place in future. And we repeat the statement that we have already given about the future in the past. Okay, when we repeat this statement, then there is no guarantee that the action has not yet taken place. For example, I said that I would go to Islamabad. I said this 10 days ago. Maybe last week I went to Islamabad and came back. So there's no guarantee. In this situation, we cannot use will or shall. Okay?
So when
you are talking in the past, okay, learn this. Okay, you will use only these words. Okay, these helping words. This is the system of the past. So that is very easy. You keep it in mind. It will add, your speeches are very good. I am very much impressed. I like them very much. And honestly, I say that you deserve 9+. Okay, you are so fluent. And your ideas were very good. Your language was very good. Everything was perfect. But the only once or twice I saw that you were shuffling from present to past or past to present. You can shuffle, okay? But it must be, this shuffling must be with your knowledge, with your permission. Is it difficult to remember? If you are my student?
No.
If you are my
student? No, I don't think so.
This is a kism ka taweez hai, theek hai? Agar aap my student, to apne paas rakhein, ye aapki bahut help karega. Ye
like,
देखें लिस्ट मैं उर्दू में बात कर रहा हूँ जो जो एग्जामिनर है दो चीजें जो हैं और बहुत छोटी छोटी बातें भी नोट करता होगा दो चीजें वो पर्टिकुलरली बड़ी इमीडिएटली नोट करता है एक तो शफलिंग प्रेजेंट पास्ट की शफलिंग जो है वो बहुत जल्दी जो है उसको पता चल जाता है क्योंकि ये चीजें उसके दिमाग में है जब मैन यू आर ब्रेकिंग दिस सर्कल ओके ये एक सर्कल है वाज वर हैड एस प्लस टू कुड वुड जब आप इसको छोड़ेंगे फौरन पता चल जाएगा कि ये थिंकिंग इन द पास्ट बट टेल यूजिंग अदर साइंस ये नहीं है ये फौरन पता चल जाता है इससे भी बड़ा नहीं है जो ज्यादा बड़ी वो है यूज ऑफ वर्ब आपने फर्स्ट फॉर्म कहाँ यूज करनी है सेकंड कहाँ करनी है थर्ड कहाँ करनी है वेरिंग फॉर्म यहाँ करनी है इनका जो है इम्प्रॉपर यूज जो है एग्जामिनर इंस्टेंटली फौरन उसको पता चल जाता है और इस तरह की जो रॉन्ग यूज ऑफ वर्ब फॉर्म जो है वो बहुत ज्यादा आपके मार्क्स जो है उससे बैंड जो है वो आपका खराब हो सकता है क्योंकि एग्जामिनर जो है वो बहुत बोल्ड हो जाता है अगर आप जो है उनके जो है वर्ब फॉर्म्स का ठीक इस्तेमाल कर आई विल टेल यू टुमारो इफ यू ज्वाइन सम और इट्स सम अदर क्लास आज तो मैंने बहुत लंबी क्लास कर दी इट वॉज फर्स्ट डे आई वॉन्टेड यू टू स्पीक मैं चाहता था कि आप बोलें ठीक है तो आई डिडंट मैंने कोई कमेंट्स नहीं दिया कुछ नहीं किया जब आप बोल ही रही थे तो मैंने क्या कमेंट्स देने थे ठीक है सो इन द एंड इट वाज जो मेरे नॉलेज में है जो इफ आई हैव सम मोर स्किल इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस ये जो चीजें हैं मैंने जब पहली आपकी मेरी क्लास हुई थी इयर्स अगो उस वक्त भी मेरे दिमाग मैंने मेरे दिमाग में थी आज भी मेरे दिमाग में है सो दे आर सो इम्पोर्टेंट बाकी अदर मैंने उस वक्त क्या कहा था आई फॉरगॉट अबाउट मुझे नहीं याद कि मैंने क्या कहा था उसके बाद पता नहीं किस किस को क्या क्या बातें की लेकिन ये वाली चीजें हैं दे डजंट क्योंकि ये दे आर सो इम्पोर्टेंट मुझे पता है कि मैं अगर ये भूल गया तो ये टेंसेज हैं एक्चुअली टेंसेज आर प्रेजेंट पास्ट फ्यूचर थ्री टेंसेज होते हैं प्रेजेंट पास्ट फ्यूचर ये नहीं है अगर मैं इनको भूल जाऊं तो टेंसेज मेरे कंट्रोल से बाहर हो जाते हैं मुझे नहीं पता रहता प्रेजेंट कौन सा है पास्ट कौन सा फ्यूचर कौन सा है तो टू कीप देम माय ग्रिप ऑन प्रेजेंट पास्ट फ्यूचर मैंने सिर्फ ये याद रखे हुए और अभी याद कर लें इट डजंट टेक टाइम याद कर लें याद रखें ठीक है इसको मेक देम पार्ट ऑफ योर लाइफ सारी जिंदगी टेंसेस आपको प्रॉब्लम नहीं करेंगे ठीक है माय गारंटी
जी
नहीं आई एम वेरी हैप्पी यू डिजर्व 9+ रियली 9+ एंड आई विश यू बेस्ट ऑफ लक व्हेन यू अपीयर इन द टेस्ट इसमें कुछ टाइम लिमिट है आपने जो है यू हैव टू डू इट लाइक यू हैव टू स्पीक 1 मिनट्स एंड आई लेट यू स्पीक फॉर 5-10 मिनट्स ओके doesn't matter,
okay.
But I'm sure when you go for actual test, आप कुछ और YouTube पे भी हैं अवेलेबल, टेस्ट हैं 9 band 8 band, यू कैन लिसन टू देम एंड योर स्पीचेस आर वेरी गुड. ओके, देयर आर ग्रेट फ्रेंड्स.
ओके,
बाकी जो है आज क्लास लेंगे?
आई डोंट नो, मैं पूछ के आपको बता सकती हूँ.
हाँ,
नहीं नहीं, सो नहीं गया लेकिन इधर है नहीं, आई डोंट नो के क्या कर रहे हैं.
अच्छा ठीक है, मैं उनसे फोन पर बात कर लेता हूँ. ओके,
ओके,
टाइम,
थैंक्स,
गुड लक. ओके,
ओके, बेस्ट, थैंक यू, थैंक्स अ लॉट, अल्लाह हाफिज़.